everyone, this video is about tax and spend policy and how ridiculous it is. And really our economy has been based around it for such a long period of time. This is a very basic chart that unfortunately doesn't have any math. But this is the neoliberal New World Order, which is what is collapsing and what we lived under for so long. And you have your tax slaves on the outside that get no benefits, but they're forced to pay into the system at gunpoint. And then around the circle, you have your white-collar government employees, and they're essentially receiving tax money to pay tax, right, to spend, and this cycle just keeps going and going and going. So such a large component of their bills are taxes to pay people to pay their taxes. It's like, it's just a shell game, right? And the real economy suffocates. The tax slaves suffocate because they're outside of the circle. They're outside of society. They're not considered members of society. They're slaves. And this is where so much suffering comes from. This is the source of such a great deal of suffering and a great deal of poverty. It really is like ostracism, but you're stealing. Not only are you ostracizing them, you're stealing half their income, half of their hard-earned income, and not building enough housing, all that stuff too. So this is the new economy. This is where we're headed. Hopefully, I got my fingers crossed. I don't know. We'll see. I like to try and stay optimistic, I guess, especially after this last few days. So we have the government here. And then you have your UBI system. Now, the taxpayers, in arcology, you would actually not even have that in arcology. So, actually, I guess with the syntax, if you count the syntaxes and you count the child tax, these would be smaller, though. They'd be a little bit smaller. There we go. And then this would be your larger landlords. And your factory owners would be the big taxpayers. They get a little UBI too, you know. They get some too. And then this is your stay-at-home mom would be here. And we might throw disabled in here too. Disabled, elderly. There we go. So, you know, there's no shame in and just collecting your UBI, right? That's why it's there. So this is the more ideal society. This is a objectively better society, and this is what we need to work towards. So notice this one is, oh, my wheel mouse is terrible. I'm so sorry. My wheel mouse is like busted. I got an old mouse. Anyway, this is all about GDP. It's all about cycling money around, shuffling money around, because you need to get those GDP numbers as high as possible. And that was like the focus. If you turn on the news, I don't know if you guys remember this, before everyone woke up, when everyone was still asleep, everything was GDP. GDP, GDP, GDP. All day, every day on the news. You open up the Wall Street Journal, it's all about GDP. You open up the New York Times, it's all about GDP. Everything is GDP. And it's just this is what it is. This is all it was. Tax and spend. So when we're getting away from that, look, this doesn't have like the same thing going on. Yeah, there's like money changing hands with the UBI and stuff, but like, I wouldn't even care. I mean, you don't want the taxes to be very high and the UBI to be very high, because then you run into the same problems you had before, except now the tax slaves are not ostracized because the universal aspect of the universal basic income does not result in this ostracism of tax slaves. But you still run into the same problem of shuffling money around for the sake of shuffling money around and having the system kind of suffocate the natural order of things. Anyway, that's it. Thank you and have a nice day.
it's over. Nobody wins.
If you want to see a new and better world come to fruition, as I do, then like, share, and subscribe. You can find an incredible amount of math, knowledge, and 3D renders by clicking on the channel name. And remember, we need you to help spread this vision across the internet for all to see and become familiar with. Let us build this new world together.